So what I'd like to tell you about is a generalization of both MDPs and repeated games that goes by the name stochastic games, also sometimes Markov games.
Mm.
I like the name Markov game better, but I use stochastic games because that's what other people call it, and sometimes it's good to use words that other people use. And what stochastic games give us is a formal model for multi-agent reinforcement learning. In fact, I like to think of this in terms of an analogy, which is something like MDP is to RL as stochastic game is to multi-agent RL. It's a formal model that lets us express the sorts of problems that take place in this formalized problem setting.
Hmm. That sounds very promising.
Cool. All right. So let me give you, I'll start off by explaining it in terms of an example, and then I'll give a more formal definition because, you know, I can't not. So this is a little game played between A and B. Oh, I should have it between Smoove and Curly, but traditionally it is played between A and B.
Mm. And sometimes it's good to use the words that other people use.
I've heard that, but I wouldn't say it quite that way. So this is a 3x3 grid. Each of the players can go north, south, east, and west, and can stay put if that's helpful. And the transitions are deterministic, except for through these walls here, which are called semi-walls. So these mm-hmm. thick lines represent walls that you can't go through. The thin lines just represent cell boundaries. But this kind of dashed line here is a semi-wall, and that means if you try to go through that, say by going north from, if A goes north from this position, then 50% probability A will actually go to the next state, and 50% probability A will stay where A is. So the goal is to get to the dollar sign, and if you get to the dollar sign, you get $100. So if we ignore A for a second, what should B do to minimize the number of steps necessary to get the reward?
Go left and then go up, then go up. Or I'm sorry, go west and then go north and then go north.
Yeah. And what should A do, ignoring B?
Go east and then go north and then north.
Yeah. Unfortunately, these guys mm-hmm. live in the world together. And what happens is they can't occupy the same square. And as soon as somebody reaches the dollar sign, the game ends. And the other player, if the other player hasn't reached the dollar sign, gets nothing.
I see.
So now there's a little bit of contention.
So what happens if A and B both try to go to the same square at the same time?
Let's say that we flip a coin and one of them gets to go first, and then the other one will bounce off of the first one.
But that's not a problem when it comes to reaching the money.
But it's not a problem. Yes, right. So the money is kind of like a money pit.
I don't think that's what a money pit is, but okay.
And so they can dive in and they both get the money because they're in the money pit.
I like it.
So what do you do if you're A? How do you play this game? Oh, let's think of another thing. Can you think of what it might mean to have a Nash equilibrium in a game like this?
Oh, that's an interesting question. It would mean that neither one of them would want to deviate.
It would mean a pair of strategies for the two mm-hmm. players. Now, the strategies are now multi-step things that say they're like policies, right? So, like, it's a pair of policies such that neither would prefer to switch. So can you think of a pair of policies that would have that property?
Well, no, I'm not sure. I was trying to think about that. So I was thinking that kind of if I were a nice guy, what I'd want to do is I'd want to us both to try to go through the semi walls. And if we both go through the semi walls, we just go up again, and then we hit the dollar sign at the same time, and that's very nice.
So okay, good. So that seems like a cooperative kind of strategy, right? Where they're both, 25% of the time, both will get through, both will go to the goal together. Hooray. But
25% of the time, neither one will get through, and then we're in the same place we were before, so that's okay.
That's
the problem
right.
is the other 50% where one of them gets through and the other doesn't.
Right. So what do you do if you make it through and the other one doesn't?
What do I do if I get through and the other one doesn't? Well, if I'm only going to do this the one time, then I just keep going and get the dollar and the other person loses.
Yeah. All right. So what this works out to be is that A is going to get to the goal two-thirds of the time, and B is going to get to the goal two-thirds of the time.
Mm-hmm.
So, all right, so if that's the case, if I say, okay, A, that's what you should do, B, that's what you should do, then is there a way that either A or B can switch strategies and do better?
Well, if B, for example, decides to go west and then go up, what happens?
Yes, that's a good question. B will now make it to the goal 100% of the time, and A will only make it to the goal 50% of the time. So B has an incentive to switch to this strategy if we tell them to both go through the semi-wall.
Right.
So that wasn't a Nash equilibrium. B would want to switch to this new policy.
Mm-hmm.
Is this a Nash equilibrium?
No. Wait, is it? No. Because why doesn't A just choose to go west, east?
Well, would A do better on average by switching to this strategy?
Well, let's see. No, actually. Oh, no. You said half the time they go through.
Yeah.
So half the time you flip a coin. So half the time I don't make it.
Right.
But half the time I do. So actually, right. It looks the same.
It looks the same. That's right.
And B would go from 1 to 1/2.
Yeah, that's true. So A doesn't have an incentive to do it, but B is hoping very much that A doesn't do that.
Right.
So there's one Nash equilibrium where B takes a center, another one where A takes a center. I guess if we do this coin flip thing, it works out this way. If it's the case that if they both if we change the rules here so that if they collide, neither of them gets to go, then both trying to go to the center is not a Nash equilibrium anymore because you can do better by actually going up the semi wall.
Right. And so if collision means nobody goes through, then suddenly you would want to do the other thing where
exactly.
One of you goes through the semi wall and one goes the direct way.
Right. So we can see that there's a bunch of different Nash equilibria here, and that it's not so obvious how you'd find them, but it is at least clear that they exist and they have a different form than what we had before, because now they're policies instead of these otherwise simplified, choose this row of the matrix.
Mm-hmm.
Cool. All right. So let's think about how we might learn in these kinds of environments.
Oh, okay. I like that already.